From providing oxygen, which is essential to our species, to serving as a food source for mankind, plants play a crucial role in the lives of humans. Since plants are necessary for our survival, organizations have researched the many ways that these organisms can be grown in outer space in order to prepare for life on other planets.
There are obvious benefits to growing plants in outer space. Along with a source of nutrition, growing plants in space offers the astronauts psychological benefits, such as stress reduction, mood improvement, and alleviation of depression. Growing plants can also provide sources of fresh oxygen, recycled water, and building materials from plant waste. Plants used for food and oxygen can also play an important role in our ability to live for long-duration missions on the Moon, Mars, and other habitable planets.
The three plants we chose grow fully in a short period of time, making them readily available for consumption. Our first choice is the red romaine lettuce. It grows quickly in large amounts and it takes about 33 days to grow. Not only that, but it offers sustenance to our crew members. In order to grow this plant, we suggest using a plant pillow. A plant pillow is a device that was created specifically to grow plants in outer space. Inside the pillow, there's control-release fertilizer, water, and calcined clay, which helps with aeration. The pillow has a slit at the top where wood can be inserted, which has a sticky surface to keep the seed in place and also helps draw water from the pillow to the plant. Red and blue LED lights are used as their light source.
The second plant we propose taking into outer space is the snake plant, otherwise known as the mother-in-law's tongue. It comes in over 70 different varieties and provides more oxygen than any other plant in the world. Although it does not provide nutrients, it is still a great choice for taking into outer space because it improves the oxygen levels in the International Space Station. NASA has discovered that snake plants remove toxins from the air such as benzene and formaldehyde. Snake plants do not need specific air humidity or light conditions, only small amounts of water, making it a very versatile plant.
Our third choice is the potato plant. Seed potato production was actually tested in 1995 aboard the Space Shuttle Columbia, where five small potatoes were actually grown in their microgravity facility. Evidently, this is a great crop to grow in outer space. Potatoes are a great source of carbohydrates, and on top of that, they provide twice the amount of food that other crops do using the same amount of lighting. What's interesting about this plant is that it could be grown from the eyes of other potatoes. So once a small batch has been grown, you can grow more continuously. In order to plant this crop, we plan on using unique lighting technology and tilter trays using a hydroponic recirculating system, which has actually been proven to be great to grow tubers.
Evidently, discovering new ways to grow plants in outer space will be beneficial to the future of mankind. Thanks for watching!